everybody, it's Pandora. I'm back for another video. It's been a while. I do apologize. Anybody who subscribed to this channel, I really do apologize. I haven't really been pushing out a lot of content this year or at the start of this year. Every now and again, Andy, you know who you are, you pop into my inbox when it comes to in-game, and you're asking me when I'm pushing new content out. So yeah, I suppose thanks for getting on my back there, Andy, and reminding me that I need to push more content out. So yeah, I do appreciate it. This is the one-to-one B, sorry, the tier 10 Chinese medium. I picked this up around Christmas. There was a pretty unique offer around Christmas time for 20,000 gold, and there was also another offer for some gold at the time. For a pretty good offer, a good discounted price. So I picked up some of the gold and I got myself this little baby. Now, I'll be honest, I did feel a little bit guilty when I got this tank. I did buy it, or I did exchange it for gold, and there's divided opinion out there when it comes to people's ability to actually buy their way into tier 10. I would consider myself quite experienced. I've got over 30,000 games played. I've got other tier 10 tanks. But believe it or not, you do get called a noob quite a bit in this tank. I did look at some of the other reviews, and it wasn't a crate tank. It used to be a crate tank in the past. The offer that came up, it wasn't a crate offer, and it was a really good offer at the time. So I decided to splash some gold, throw 20,000 gold on it, and pick up the tank. And I had a look at some of the other reviews at the time. Most of the opinions were the same, and that basically they all agreed that it was a really, really decent tank. So yeah, I bit the bullet, and I traded gold for it. So I just want to call that out. If you've got this tank, you will get called a gold noob sometimes, but you know, that's the game. Okay, and one other thing about this tank is the legendary camo. Now, I can't leave this out of the video. This looks wicked, right? That gold plated dragon on the front, the combination of the gold and the black. And I'll admit, like, Wargaming, they don't really release good camos for tanks. I'm very, very fussy when it comes to that. But if there's ever a discounted offer on this camo that pops up on the edge of the screen, I'm definitely going to get it. I think it really, really makes this tank distinctive. And it makes it look very Chinese with that, like, gold-plated dragon on the front. A quick mention on the equipment then. I've kind of toyed with this back and forth over the last couple of weeks. For my equipment loadout, I go with the rammer. It makes the tank a lot more effective when it comes to dealing with other mediums. It boosts the DPM, and it makes it a lot more effective when it comes to dealing with other mediums quickly. So that's why I go with that. Vitality, I go with defense system. I go with that because it minimizes injury to my crew, and I think that's a bit more important, especially for a medium. Specialization, I go with optics or camo net. I go with optics, a bit of a no-brainer. It increases the view range to 302. Not really need to talk about that more. Between enhanced gun lane drive and supercharge, I actually go with enhanced gun lane drive. Now, I did have this previously on supercharge, but I think the enhanced gun lane drive, anything that minimizes the time of target, anything to aim, that's going to help. Next one then, I go with enhanced armor. Anything to help increase that turret armor, I tend to just go with that. I think it makes the most sense. Then between the next one, improved control or the engine accelerator, I go engine accelerator. It's a bit of a no-brainer. You don't really need to traverse that quickly like a heavy would need to. So that's why I go with that. And it also increases the power to weight ratio. For the 7 slot, it's a bit controversial. It's between the V-Stab and the refined gun. Now, I go with the refined gun because it decreases dispersion. You could also go with the V-Stab, which would also help reduce the aim time. But for me, I just go with the refined gun. For the next two, then, you've got the toolbox or the enhanced tracks. I usually just go with the toolbox. Anything that decreases the time to fix modules, I will always pick that. And then for the last slot, then, I go with high-end consumables. Because of my loadout and with my use of consumables, I think that's the better option. This is just a quick mention. This is the tank to arm inspector, and this is through the scopes of a Leo 1. Now, as you can see, that hole, most things at tier 10 are going to pen that. You're working with 120mm, so I just wanted to call that out. You can also see from the screen that that is a very strong turret. So you can play this thing hold down. It has got 6 degrees of gun depression. You can also brawl with this tank. So when you see another medium, you can push that turret into the gun, and most of the time you're going to bounce the shots. And now we're going to move on to some gameplay. I've got 3 games today. Hopefully this will showcase the tank, show you the strengths and the weaknesses, and hopefully you enjoy. Alright, and for the first game, it's Game of Supremacy on the Normandy map. I think this is the first time this map is actually featured on my channel. It's a very nice map. The only thing I have with it is that the colours are very, very dark. I always find myself having to adjust the brightness on my screen. But other than that, it's a really nice map. I really like it. So looking at the team makeup, there's not a lot of mediums and lights. There's only a batch out of myself. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to push up towards the B cap here. It's a really nice area for doing some spotting on this map. So I'm pushing all the way up. I'm actually going to push all the way up and see what I can spot on the back. So I'm going to push up towards this mill and then I'm going to pull back. So push up, we do manage to spot two tanks. It's 183 and a T-62. Now the T-62 seems to be pushing to the right. There's other tanks here. There's an E-4 who's pushed down to the beach. So we've spotted up some of their tanks. I'm not going to push into the B cap yet. Now, I get a little bit nancy here. Do get a little bit pissy because I'm spotting here and there's nobody supporting us. But the Batchat's engaged me. He's managed to bounce a shot from him, but he does manage to get me here. The damn Clippers, I hate them. But he's now on a reload, I think. He's done really, really well to get me, but he's pushing right. So I know that most of the team is on the right-hand side. There's the 183 at the back. I want to pay particular attention to him. There's an E100. He's behind a bunker for whatever reason. Try and put a shot in there. Now, I don't know if that pinged or not. I don't want to be taking unnecessary damage, so I want to try and keep holding down or not in view of their attacks. There's a 183 at the back. Gonna put a shot into him. 350 alpha, not bad. He's nearly a one shot arrow. Trying to give him. There we go. Okay, so we take a shot there. 930. We do bounce it. All you could see was my turret. We do manage to high roll and get a shot in on him, so not a bad trade. I'm gonna push down here. The E4, I can't see him at this point in time, but he's actually on the left hand side. I'm keeping an eye on the rest of the team just to see where they are. Now, I make a bit of a mistake here. I'm going to push on to try and help the batch out on the left, hit this E4, but I make a mistake. I actually push too far ahead. Don't take a shot. Now I take a shot. Manage to hit him. Do okay, but all this time I'm in the sights of the E100. He puts a shot in, takes half my hit points, well over half my hit points, and causes an engine fire. But we do manage to take out the E4. He's dead. Is it? This E100, I need to push and need to actually engage on this guy. So pushing on up and see if we can get a shot. Do put a shot in, no problem. The batch has pushed. He's reloaded. He's pushing him. So I'm going to try and support him. Track the E100. Give that batch some breathing space. And he's trying to do a COD. So put some shots in there. 370 alpha. Not bad. Now the batch has on a reload. So I'm going to try and push on and help him. He's gone down to the beach to reload, but the E100's followed him. I'm going to try and put some shots on this E100. There we go, another shot, 350 alpha. The Batchat's reloaded now and he manages to take him out. So not bad, managed to take him out, but the Batchat has lost a lot of hit points. So trying to get back up this beach is a pain. A lot of tanks actually struggle on this, but there's a T-62A. Stupidly, like, I shouldn't have taken that shot. Really, really optimistic there, but he's going right. I'm going to let him go right. I'm going to push up to try and help this T-57 Heavy, who's just used his last shot on an IS-4, and he's balling them. So he's going to go down and down. Yeah, well, there he goes. Try and put a shot on the IS-4. That bounces, of course. There's something following me. I think it's a T-62. I've managed to put a shot in on me. Now, I make a mistake here. I go for the IS-4. I should have really gone for the T-62. The T-62 misses his shot, though. Gonna put another shot in this IS-4, but he's taking out the Batchat. Put a shot in on him. And the T-62, like the grill misses his shot. I thought he would have caught me. And I try and brawl with the T-62, push my turret out, he's gone. He manages to kill me. Fair play to him. The grill manages to take out the T-62 inevitably. Eventually, is the word. And it's 3-1. Just the IS-4 left and we managed to take him out, so not too bad. 3.4 and managed to bounce 1,500 damage. Not a bad game. From the replay, it said 3.4, but we actually did more damage. We got 4.1 damage, 56,000 credits, one kill. Not a bad first game. 3 minutes and 46 seconds. Very, very quick. The damage just racks up with this 105mm, so it's a really good gun. Really good for getting the damage in. And yeah, not bad for a first game. Alright, and on to the second game. It's another game of Supremacy, and it's on Dead Rail. Team makeup seems to be... There's a lot more mediums on this team. So, we've spawned on the south side. And I'm gonna push on towards the C cap here. Try and get up there, see what develops, and see what team, see what mediums maybe be attracted to the C cap. So let the team know that I'm going to see, and they're actually following me as well. Now you can see the tank just flies, like it takes off pretty well. It's actually faster than an Object 140 taking off. So managed to get up here in no time, pretty quick. And we're just going to see what develops on the C-cap. I don't want to... I just want to use this cover really smartly. So I'm very, very hesitant there. There's the 4202. He's pushed and peaked the hill. He does get me spotted. And I'm just keeping an eye on the left-hand side here just to see what their heavies do. There is an IS-8 that's spotted down there. Just keeping an eye on him, see if we can do some damage. I do get spotted gun, and there's the 4202. I'm tunneling. I'm tunneling. I do take a shot there from the 4202, and he does do some damage to my gas tank. I do find it quite a bit that the gas tank does get damaged quite a bit in this tank. We do have some backup here. Some of the Reds are taking shots as well. The WZ-120 at the back with the Leo. Leo is focusing someone else, so we'll put a shot in on him. The 4202 is still here, so I'm pulling back. I don't want to take unnecessary damage from him. I'm waiting for the rest of the team to show, but he is taking damage there. So the rest of the team, we have spotted him up, and he is taking damage, the 4202. Here comes the VK. FV is focusing the VK, so I'll put a shot in on him. But that's a really, really low roll. And he goes for the VK. This is where we need to move now. Push the WZ, managed to take him out. And the 4202 is making his getaway, but he manages to get taken out. It's a nice 8, put a shot in, another really bad low roll, 287. He's just taking a shot, so I'm trying to put a shot in on him, and I bounce it. At all the time in the world there, I should have taken more time. Should have got that shot. But the Leo's still up here, he's focused on someone else, going to try and put a shot in at him, and I messed that up. Should have taken more time with that one, I rushed that one. So the Waffen's at the back, Leo's here, we've got two spotted here, so I'm just keeping an eye on him. I don't think the Reds can shoot me in this position. Try and take a blind shot there in the Waffen. I don't know if that hit him or not. And I'm going to try and push, see if we can kill this Leo. Waffen gets spotted again. He's at the back. Load up HT. And we do get a big shot there. There's a high roll 432 with HT, which isn't too bad. Yeah, he's still there at the back. Now I'm going to take a bit of a blind shot there. I don't know if that got him or not. I think it did. Leo's still retreating. T62 takes him out. So I'm going to try and push this Waffen. He's still there. He's definitely still there. So pushing down really, really fast. And he's trying to make a getaway now at this point. Now, I think there's another TD on the far side of that map. And I think that's why he's pushed down this side. So I want to try and push down, take this guy out as soon as possible. So he's focusing the T62. Managed to take him out. I'm trying to get back into cover because I think the TD is on the other side. So there's an E100 and there's a Jagdpanzer E100. Now, I don't know where the Jagdpanzer is, but I have a fairly good idea of where he is. The E100 takes out one of the greens there, and I'm pushing back towards the other side of this map. I want to take out this E100. And all this time, I'm trying not to get proxy spotted. He's behind this building, but I'm just trying not to stick too close to the building so he'll spot me. But I do get spotted here. Spot him up, do manage to get a shot in. I'm trying to put my tank in this position where that Jagdpanzer E100 on the far side of the map can't shoot me. So trying to push shots in this E100, and we are taking shots. I don't know if you hear them right there, but we are taking shots that are missing me. I do take a shot from the E100 there, bad shot, but I think he's using heat, kind of low rolls using heat. And I hesitate here. I don't know if I should have pushed or not, but I hesitate. I'm going to push on the C100, get a lovely little shot on the lower glacis. We do bounce a shot there for 460. I think that was a heat gel. I don't know. We do manage to take him out. So, not too bad. There's only one tank left. There's a 183. Now, I don't want to take the B cap here. I know what the VK is saying. He's saying the cap, but I don't want a cap. I have a fairly good idea where this guy is. So I'm going to push out, try and spot him as soon as possible. There he is. He's right where I thought he was. So giving him all the signs of where I am. I'm knocking down trees stupidly, but he does miss his shot. He's on a reload. So I'm going to peek over this hill and trying to put some shots in. I rushed that. I should have taken my time with that. And he's trying to traverse. Put a shot in on him there. Now, could have maybe tried to stop him traversing, but I'm going to try and wait for the rest of the team to support me. And I push back in and around. He's traversed in and around. I'm not going to take a shot there. That's a really optimistic shot, but I do take a shot. But I bounce it, 800. He can only see my turret. And here's the T-62A. Trying to stop this guy traversing. I should have got closer. Now I was trying to stop him. Put a shot in. T-62 also puts a shot in. And he's just traversing. Like, I can't stop him traversing. I take a mad shot there. But he makes a mistake. He goes for the T-62. So I've got free rein here. Putting shot after shot after shot. The T-62 does really, really well, but the Jagdpanzer should have went for me. Should have taken me out. Push shots in the back of him. T-62 is doing well. It's just a matter of taking him out here. I'm not just finishing him off. T-62 did really well. Fair play to him for supporting me. And yeah, some really good teamwork there at the end. We managed to ace it. We do get the top gun. We do get the high caliber. 4.9, 73,000 credits, 4 kills, 1,500 experience. We also get 892 assisted damage. So, good game. I thought that was a low ace, because I remember back in the day I aced my Type 59, I think, with that damage. But I'm happy with that. I'll take it. So onto the third and final game. It's a game in Port Bay in Canada Battle. Looking at the lineup, we've got a light and we've got a medium. They've only got one medium. So I'm actually going to push out into the corner here. We've spawned on the northwest. I'm going to push over into the corner in the northeast. Hopefully their team shows up. They've only got a T-54E1. And I know that tank is pretty slow. And it's only a tier 9. So I'm going to push out here. I'll see if they show up. I didn't think they would actually show up, but a bit of a giveaway here. They do actually show up. So I'm just really taking a bit of a gamble at this point, because I don't know if they're going to show up. Try and get this corner and secure a nice little position to get some shots across. And I was a little bit worried here at this point. None of the reds are showing up. And at this point, you usually do spot them. So if they don't start showing, you're kind of wondering, oh crap, they haven't showed up. So the E5 has shown up. There's an IS-7. I'm going to try and pot a shot on him. I'm just waiting for him to peek. And I just bounce a shot because, you know, it's an IS-7. Don't even track him. Here's the T-54E1. He's a clipper. He's looking for that shot on me. He's just going to sit there. So I managed to bounce his shot and put another one into him. Got two shots into him. There's three shots into him. And he hasn't got any shot into me. And he's wasted his clip. So, yeah, there's the SU-122-54. Put a shot into him. Get a high roll, 438. Really nice to see. There's the E-100. Gonna take another shot in the SU. I bounced that shot. Now, I don't know what he does here. I don't know why he just didn't stay there. But he manages to... He pushes on down towards a mouse. He's more in the town area. So there's a 183 down there. Try and put a shot in at him. And of course, I have to hit the mantlet. I should have used heat there, but yeah, just didn't get that shot in. Try again, another mantlet shot. I don't take the shot in return. I'm only giving him my turret. He can only see my turret, but he manages to take a hit there and actually back up. That's when I put a shot into him. So can I get a second? No, we don't. E100 is also in there, so I'm just gonna, yeah, there he is. Put a shot into him. We take a shot there for 235. I don't know what that is that hit me. And here's the E100. He's focusing on me now. I can't believe he hit that shot. I think he fired HE there for 143. Still not getting that many shots in on him. He clearly knows what he's doing. And I obviously don't know what I'm doing aiming for the mantlet. But yeah, there's the SU-122-54. Putting another shot into him. It's just a matter of farming. I was lucky enough to get into this position. There's the Dead Star. Put a shot into him. And I'm trying not to stay in the one position for too long. So I'm just kind of moving forward, moving back. Wash, rinse, repeat. There's another shot into the 183. He's focusing now. There's a high roll on him. Should be maybe a one shot, maybe a two shot now. Okay, two shot, 340. There's the E100. Now he's starting to make a push towards our IS-7, who's managed to flank in around. haven't taken too much HP off this guy, so I'm trying to get the shots in here. As you can see, 5k damage there. Trying to put more and more shots in. There's another one. And I kind of want to stop him here. I should have really got a track shot here, but I missed that shot. To try and help the IS-7. But there's the 183. I managed to finish him off. And I'm going to push. I'm not going to sit still. We've got 3 versus 2. They've done pretty well. In fairness to the Reds, they have done pretty well. But our heavies have really acted like heavies. So here I am. I'm on the roof. I'm using my engine boost here. I tend to find that the tank's a little bit sluggish, so I do tend to use engine boost. So pushing in here to the E-100. IS-7 has done really, really well, just brawling with them really. And it's just a matter of me putting shots in the back of them here. Just managed to finish them off there. The E-5 is down here with the mouse. The motion, he's done pretty well. I managed to finish him off, so managed to finish the E-5. 5.8 damage, and that's surely an ace. Just manage a farm damage there, and we do. Yeah, we get the ace, high caliber scouts medal. 5.8, as I said. 1500 experience, three kills, three frags, and 561 assisted damage. So all in all, not a bad game. I was just lucky to get into that spot, to be honest. But you know, you gotta be in to win it. Not a bad game. Happy with that. And that's it. That's the 1-to-1B. It's an alternative to your T-62A or your Object 140. If you haven't got one of those two tanks, I think you might be interested in getting this tank. I would bear in mind that it is a Tier 10 premium. There's a separate discussion around whether people are entitled to get the tank or if they should just buy it. I'm not going to go into it in this video. You know, at some point in the future, Wargaming are probably going to put this tank up for sale again. And the last time it was up for sale, the last two times it was up for sale, it was 17,500 gold. I suppose the thing that's interesting about the tank is the gun, really, the 105mm gun. It's a little bit quicker off the mark than an Object 140. I can't really talk about the T-62. I haven't really got that tank yet. Well, I haven't got it yet. I have got it researched. If you're still watching at this point, thank you for still watching. These videos are a little bit long, and I'm going to try and keep them a little bit shorter going forward. And I do apologize about some of the variances in the volume. I'm aware that there was a little bit of a difference between the three videos, so I'm going to try and nail that down. This was recorded over two different weekends, so that kind of explains why there was a little bit of a variance between the volume, I suppose. Thanks for watching. At this point, I'm going to let you go. Hopefully I'll catch you in the next one. Cheers. Thanks.